Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani, and today I'm going to show you one of the most sought-after treatments, combination treatment in the United States today. Now, combination treatments are all the rage because most people that come in need a combination or a series of treatments to really achieve what they're seeing on social media and Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube. And today, we're doing a combination of PDO threads, polydioxinone threads, and they're going to be smooth, combined with PRF, platelet-rich fibrin, hyaluronic acid filler, and the PRF mixed together for the under eye, and microcannula lip injections, all to achieve the great result that the patient's really requesting. So here I mix the PRF platelet-rich fibrin with hyaluronic acid, and I'm injecting it under the eye with the microcannula technique. The microcannula in the mid-face is my go-to because there's a lot of vessels and nerves that we want to avoid, and the microcannula provides a more comfortable, safer treatment with less bruising. Now here we're filling the under eye, or what many people call the tear trough or the nasojugal groove area, and it's one of the most sought after treatments that people come in requesting and that clinics want to provide, but it's also the most difficult. So adding platelet-rich fibrin has been revolutionary for me because you get a much smoother look. It helps, I think, improve the existing fat cells around the eye, makes them healthier, helps with dark circles and the shadowing. And the younger generation, they just want a little volume in the anterior cheek. Now this is one of my most favorite treatments because it's fairly quick and it does several things. If we look at the bone around the eye, it expands and so we lose brow projection and also hair growth. So I'm adding platelet-rich fibrin to the area above the brow for both of these things. We're improving projection, but we're also helping with hair growth around the eye, particularly a nice vibrant brow. Now here, I'm adding PRF alone to the direct under eye. The reason is it's typically just loose, crepey skin that people want to treat here. You don't really need to add filler in this region. And PRF has mesenchymal stem cells. It also has growth factors, white blood cells, and it forms that fibrin clot. So there's a slow release of the growth factors, which makes the lid cheek junction look very smooth. Now we're moving on to the PDO threads. I'm adding smooth above the brow. I think smooth threads are underutilized and we underdose them. But adding them above the brow helps build collagen. It adds a little bit of volume and facial fat. There isn't a lot of it in the forehead. So to add a little bit of volume looks healthier and gives a nice projection. And over time, it lifts the brow a little bit. And everyone likes a more lifted, awake, rested looking eye. Now this area is also most sought after. If we add PDO threads, and these are smooth, you could move up to barbed threads if you wanted a little more result, but the smooth are quick, and it's surprising how much result you get, especially in a combined treatment to lift the oral commissure, the edge of the mouth. And just about everyone from the young to the aged wants less drooping of that oral commissure. And here we put the thread in, and we are in a specific plane so that we're not too deep, but we're not too shallow enough so that the thread gets engaged and we simply remove the thread and it's employed. Somewhat of an ingenious mechanism of application, but over time, you get improvement of the skin, you do get a lifting effect and collagen production that can last a year or two. Moving on to the microcannula lip injection, microcannulas are underutilized. When I'm at a conference and I ask how many people use them, it's about 15 to 30%, despite the fact that cannulas have been around since 2009, 2010 in this country. So here, I like to approach it from four openings along the edge of the lip. And when you're making that opening for the microcannula, you don't need to go very deep and you don't need to actually move in and out of the opening, but it's more of a sideways stretch on the dermis to create a wider opening, not a deeper opening. That way you don't get a bruise. We can reach many areas with the microcannula and we can actually shape the lip quite nicely. It's more comfortable, definitely less bruising, and you can still add a needle technique for the Cupid's bow if you wanted to or to fine tune it after, but it's very comfortable and actually a sought after procedure by patients to clinics when they know the microcannula is an option for them. So that's one of my favorite combination treatments. Combination treatments are very difficult to be taught by single companies. So these are things you're going to be taught more in a private training or in a group setting or a conference. Join us on Instagram, on this YouTube channel. Comment below on your favorite treatments and combinations so we can learn, and keep joining me to keep your skin beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.